Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. May I extend a very warm welcome, and may also greet the our distinguished foreign visitors by saying Aibohan, which means may you have long life. Venerable Thero, the member of the Mahasangha, the president of the council, president of CMA, the patron of the CMA, former minister, Professor G.L. Pieris, Excellency, the High Commissioner for South Africa and Sri Lanka, Professor King, Mervyn King, guest speaker, Professor Ho Yu Kui, Mrs. Caroline Williamson, President of Chartered Institute of Public Financial Accounts, UK, distinguished invitees, council members, ladies and gentlemen. I wish to thank the President and the Council of CMA Sri Lanka for inviting me this evening for the dual function of the CMA Excellence in Integrated Reporting Awards 2019 and the inauguration of the CMA National Management Accounting Conference and Commonwealth Accountants Conference. Let me also take this opportunity to thank the President of the CMA, Professor Lakshman Vatavala, for the pioneer role that he played in strengthening the accountancy profession in Sri Lanka, taking it to new heights. And we appreciate, Professor, your dedication and your commitment. Let me at the outset offer my congratulations to CMA, Sri Lanka, on its 20th anniversary celebrations. The success of CMA is seen from the large numbers who attended in this event, including the cream of the private sector and accounting professionals. CMA Sri Lanka is the National Professional Management Accounting Body incorporated by Parliament Act No. 23 of 2009 and was set up to provide a professional management accounting qualification to the youth of Sri Lanka by having our own local body and to provide a professional qualification at an affordable cost. They also need to be congratulated for receiving the membership of the International Federation of Accountants, giving it due recognition both locally and internationally. They have also received recognition in the South Asian region by becoming members of the South Asian Federation of Accountants. I have been informed that this is the fifth consecutive year in which the CMA Excellence in Integrated Reporting Award 2019 is being held, and this is the year they have received 50 applications compared to the 40 received last year, showing the recognition given to integrated reporting, especially by the public quoted companies. This is further strengthened by having the Colombo Stock Exchange as the supporting partner. I'm indeed pleased that CMA has invited Professor Mervyn King, a world-renowned authority on integrated reporting and the Chair Emeritus of the International Integrated Reporting Council, as the keynote speaker, who I'm sure will make a valuable contribution for the success of this event and to further promote integrated reporting to Sri Lanka. I must also congratulate all those speakers who made their presentation before me. It was indeed a pleasure listening to all of them. I have noted that an integrated report will show how an organization's strategy, governance, performance, and prospects in the context of its external environment lead to the creation of value in the short, medium, and long term. It has also been designed to benefit all stakeholders, including employees, customers, suppliers, business partners, local communities, regulators, and policymakers interested in the organization's ability to create value over time. A key objective of IR is to enhance accountability and stewardship with respect to the broad base of tangible and intangible capitals and promote the understanding of their interdependency. IR will also promote the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals for fighting poverty, promoting sustainable development, and improving global and local well-being. The recognition of the top performers at the CMA Excellence in Integrated Reporting Awards 2019 are commendable and will be a boost to the shareholders and other stakeholders who will be able to derive the value created by these organizations. However, I have noted that although there is a great interest from the public quoted companies in the participation of state-owned enterprises are restricted to the state banks currently regulated by the central bank, which shows that a regulator can play an important role in making state enterprises efficient, productive, and provide timely reporting, and they may be a matter worth considering for all state enterprises. It is very important that state enterprises follow global practices and implement integrated reporting to promote good management and to report the value created by this organization by the use of public funds and returns given to the state. The respective ministries, the Committee on Public Enterprises, and the Public Account Committee should make it mandatory for all these state institutions and government ministers and departments to submit integrated reports on a timely basis, making them accountable with the application of good governance principles. I must say that here we have achieved a great amount of success. And last week, you opened the proceedings of both COP and the Public Accounts Committee to the public, which has also developed into a very interesting program. I have also noted that in South Africa, it is mandatory for all companies quoted on the Johannes Stock Exchange to submit integrated reports, which has benefited these companies and its stakeholders. The theme of the conference, Sustainability Development Goals Agenda 2030, the role of the professional accountant is an area for focus for all member countries of the United Nations. There are 17 Sustainable Development Goals with 169 targets and 244 categories. As expressed by the UN, the Sustainable Development Goals are the blueprint to achieve a better and more sustainable future for all. They address the global challenge we face, including those related to poverty, inequality, climate, environmental degradation, prosperity, and peace and justice. The goals interconnect, and in order to leave no one behind, it is important that we achieve each goal and target by 2030. I have noted that the conference technical sessions will address many of the sustainable development goals. Most important sustainable development goals are the good governance, accountability, meritocracy, anti-corruption, quality education and skill development, gender equality, climate and forest cover, national security, and many others. The implementation of these goals has to be vigorously undertaken by the government, as Sri Lanka has signed the UN Declaration, and all political parties need to work in this direction if we are to achieve no poverty, good health, and disciplined society as targeted. The addresses made by keynote speaker Professor Mervyn King and special guest Professor Ho Yu Ki have addressed key matters which are important to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals and how Sri Lanka can become a developed nation. Hard work and perseverance are the two great qualities that have resulted in these successes. Law-abiding citizens and the implementation of laws not restricted to pieces of paper applicable to all citizens with no exceptions have enabled good governance and corruption-free societies to be created. I am confident that these experiences, if adopted by the government and society, will enable Sri Lanka to reach economic development and prosperity with peace and harmony before long. I'm also pleased to note the signing of the MOU between CMA, Sri Lanka, the Chartered Institute of Public Finance Accountants UK to provide education and training for public sector accountants and need to be given all the support, as this will certainly assist the government to bring in financial discipline and proper financial management to the public. We are very happy about that from a government's point of view. Education, training and skill development should be given the highest priority and is embedded in the sustainability development goals too. We also need to commence STEM education in schools where science, technology, engineering and maths will be taught in all schools, with opportunities at the universities and technical colleges to make Sri Lanka convert the large number of art students, mainly from the rural areas, to science and technology and provide job opportunities and also bring in foreign direct investment. I'm happy that the technical sessions will discuss the harnessing of human capital, creating jobs and scientific research for sustainable development. I wish to congratulate all award winners for their excellent performance at the CMA Excellence in Integrated Reporting Awards 2019 and all companies and state institutions who took part in the competition. I've been informed that an integrated reporting workshop has been organized on the 11th September after the conference by eminent experts, which will enable you to do better in preparing your integrated reports for the next year. My good wishes to the President, Professor Vattapala, and the Governing Council, management of the staff of CMA Sri Lanka, for the very well organized event, and wish them very successful conference. I wish CMA Sri Lanka success in all the activities, and that CMA will provide the lead in taking cost and management accounting and integrated reporting all sectors of private and public sector enterprises to create value to all its stakeholders. I thank you.